got a big game tonight.
Have you? Well, good luck.
Thanks.
Hello, no, darling. I've got to run. It's a busy day out here today.
Okay, miss you.
Miss you.
See you tonight.
Yeah, the board is burnt out, so if you can't send out some replacements soon, we're looking at 2 to 3 weeks downtime.
Yeah, give me a sec. Tom, where do we have one of these, and how soon can we get it to the rig?
Yeah, I'll check. We can get one by the end of the day.
To do some other stuff later on.
Great, thank you. Thanks for letting us join your call.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Oh, that's all we have planned for today, so next week's field trip is scheduled for next Tuesday.
Hi there. How's your day so far?
Going well. Busy.
I'm about to meet with a client.
Okay.
Okay.
I get some dinner from the store now.
Remember my tea.
Bye.
Much has been said about video conferencing and the cost benefits in reducing travel and carbon footprints. So when Vodafone introduced a company-wide travel reduction philosophy, it required that every employee justify why any business travel could not be replaced by using one of Vodafone's 24 Tamburg video lounges. Joining me in studio is Brian Thompson from Tamburg. Brian, welcome to the show, first of all.
Thank you, Darren. Great being here.
Now, carbon footprints and the environment is an issue that everyone's talking about at the moment. How much does video conferencing do to alleviate this problem?
I think very little is really understood when one looks at the carbon footprint and how video conferencing plays an extremely important role there. A lot of people tend to think of it more as airline travel, cutting back airline costs. But it actually goes a lot further than that. It goes to your motor vehicle. How much time do you spend in the mornings in the traffic going to work? How much time do you spend going home? Not only are you putting carbon footprint into the air, but you're wasting productivity time, you know, to and from the office. So I think from that aspect, it plays a huge role in reducing the costs of business and also as well as the carbon footprint that are associated with it.
Brian, as we saw, Vodafone is urging its clients to adopt video conferencing. How successful has this been, and are there any other companies or corporates that are doing the same?
Well, just to touch on the Vodafone one, what they've calculated, their cost in reduction of the carbon footprint is in the region of 5,500 tons per year of carbon into the atmosphere. So I think a lot of other companies have seen that study being done, and a lot of people are actually doing that. I mean, extending forward, we had people talking about exchanging carbon tokens between companies. So I think going forward, a lot more of people are going to look at video conferencing to actually up that.
So it's about creating awareness of video conferencing
very
throughout the
so.
Corporates.
Very much so, yeah.
Now, in terms of the technology and the solutions that one would use for video conferencing, tell me a little bit more about them. Are they expensive?
Well, I think most people, their view on video conferencing traditionally is what is historically the experience. A room-based system to a room-based system, boardroom, ISDN-based, bad quality, unreliable, and really, you know, people have tried it and thrown it out. With the advent of technology growth, bandwidth availability, people are moving now to what we call the HD systems, high definition.
Yeah, sure.
Much more reliable, IP-based systems, moving away from ISDN, and adoptable to in not just boardroom to boardroom, but person to person, visual communications, you know, taking it everywhere, whether no matter where you are, you now have the ability to communicate face to face.
You touched on broadband and bandwidth there. Now, a lot of people in Johannesburg have been complaining about the roads being dug up all over. But now, that is actually very good for us because it means the cost of broadband and bandwidth will come down. Is that a factor for video conferencing at the moment?
Most definitely. Bandwidth is a requirement specifically in HD systems, in high-quality solutions. So bandwidth is a requirement. And as you rightly mentioned, there's a lot of fiber going into the roads. Mm. There's a lot of fiber going countrywide, which is going to now become available as bandwidth to use for business usage, both of video and data communications.
There's been some skeptics about video conferencing. Some people would say that it eliminates the human interaction of a boardroom. What are your thoughts on that? And do you think that is more where we're moving to in terms of technology and the 21st century?
Very much so. You know, one of our clips that we have actually starts off with no visual component, just the conversation between people. And you, all of a sudden you're watching this blank screen and there's no emotion there. And then the picture comes in and then you see the emotion. And of course, going now to corporates in the personal touch, mm-hmm. that is where we now in Tandberg bring our T3 telepresence system, mm-hmm. which really gives you that feel of being across the boardroom table from someone else. All you just don't have, I guess, is the touch and the feel, but everything else is there.
Explain a little bit more about the T3 tele system. What is that?
So that's the big system that basically is boardroom to boardroom.
Okay.
That has the ability to integrate and interface into laptops and desktop systems. So you can be sitting in a boardroom environment and bring someone in from the desktop across the world as part of your boardroom meeting, just at the drop of a hat, and switch them in and switch them out. And it's really a great experience.
And what is the uptake of video conferencing been like in South Africa? Is it popular? Are we gaining momentum?
I think it's starting to pick up momentum now, and that's really with the advent of the migration from ISDN across to IP, opening the solutions up to a lot more users into corporate environments, and really just the proliferation of the visual communication, which is so great.
Brian Thompson from Tandberg, we're going to leave it there for tonight, but thanks for joining me on Tech at Work.
Darren, thank you very much.